the Philippine government setting an ambitious growth target of as much as 7.5% this year. This as they move to elevate the country's status to an upper middle income nation by 2025. Joyce Balancho reports.
The Marcos administration, bullish about the economy as it targets a 6.5 to 7.5% full-year GDP growth this 2024. The Philippines' top economist, Arsenio Balisacan, says that's in line with the government's goals of generating economic opportunities, increasing employment, raising per capita income, and elevating the Philippines to upper middle income status by 2025. He also sees improvements in sectors such as infrastructure, agriculture, services, manufacturing, among others, this year.
This growth will be supported by low and manageable inflation, a labor force with access to more and better jobs, a stronger fiscal position in the form of lower deficit and debt as a share of gross domestic product, and an increasingly dynamic, innovative, and competitive economy.
The optimism in economic growth comes as the country saw a better-than-expected 5.9% growth in the third quarter of 2023. According to Balisacan, the Philippine economy performed well last year, even in the face of a magnitude of challenges.
Our experience in the past year has led us to acknowledge the importance of reinforcing further our fiscal position to sustain rapid and inclusive growth in the coming years. But we do think that there are growth opportunities if we can move our things like, you know, we have the government has passed a number of reforms, and we are now operationalizing these reforms.
Full year 2023 growth figures will be released next week. Meanwhile, the NEDA board, chaired by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., has approved the negotiated parameters, terms, and conditions for the upgrade of the Lagundingan International Airport in Misamis Oriental. The 12.75 billion peso airport project aims to enhance regional development and promote tourism in northern Mindanao and its neighboring regions. The project will now undergo the comparative challenge process as provided by the newly enacted Public-Private Partnership Code. Also receiving the green light is the Trade Department's request to update the timeline of its 4 billion peso rural agro-enterprise project called the Rapid Growth. It aims to support 78,000 farming households by expanding both on-farm and off-farm activities and generating employment opportunities in rural areas. Balisacan says these projects will help in government's goal of achieving social and economic transformation. Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.
Secretary Balisacan expresses support for the push to amend the economic provisions of the Philippine Constitution. Balisacan says there is a need to remove what he calls unnecessary restrictions to attract more foreign investments and address issues on ease of doing business. As for the mode of amending the charter, he hopes lawmakers would soon agree on the process, saying the uncertainty could affect investor confidence.
One of the factors that inhibit investments, whether it's domestic or foreign, is state of uncertainty. You know, so we hope that our leaders will, you know, come up to a common position quickly so that we can move on. As we have seen over the last couple of decades now, most of those big investments are going to our neighbors. We could have that opportunity to draw them to our shores, but those restrictions are seen as impediments, no? Constitutional restrictions on foreign investments. No?
An advocate of the People's Initiative for Charter Change says there is a brewing constitutional crisis, but only within the upper chamber. Former House lawmaker Alfredo Garbien Jr. slams senators who oppose the ongoing campaign. He says the Senate should not fool the public by claiming the People's Initiative is illegal. Senate Majority Leader Joel Villanueva earlier warned of a constitutional crisis amid the growing rift between lawmakers over the signature campaign.
Constitutional crisis on the part of the Senate because they don't want joint voting. Pero takot na takot sila na magkaroon ng joint voting. Dahil ang checks and balance dito ay itinatapo natin sa taong bayan. Ba't naman sila matatakot kung yung may mandato to perform their checks and balance is the sovereign Filipino people. Huwag natin linlangin yung taong bayan o yung lalong-lalo na yung Senado na pag sinabi nilang joint voting anomalya. This is not a new concept. Hindi ito bagong konsepto sa ating konstitusyon.
Garvin, meanwhile, expressed readiness to face critics of the People's Initiative.
Handa kami dyan from the very start. Ang problema lang, dito sa nag-uupos, lahat lang salita. Affidavit, testimonya, keso may anomalya, lahat lang alingas-ngas. But from the very start, asan yung tatlong mayor ni Lagman? Asan yung binigyan ng ayuda? These are all allegations, perhaps false assertions, that boils down to lahat lang sabi-sabi at chismis. But the truth of the matter is, we are nearing 12%. And these are all genuine signatures signed by registered voters na naiintindihan yung kanilang pinirmahan.
Here at home, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. will depart for Vietnam on January 29 for a two-day state visit. This is Marcos's first official travel this year, but his second foreign trip after he attended the Brunei Prince's wedding 2 weeks ago. Marcos is expected to meet with Vietnamese officials, business leaders, and the 7,000 Filipino community there. The visit comes as the two countries aim to boost trade to $10 billion in the coming years. The president's trip will also involve an in-depth discussion on agricultural cooperation, especially on supporting rice supply in the Philippines.
We have selected Vietnam as the country because our relations with Vietnam have spanned for almost 50 years with the establishment of bilateral relations in 1976. As the Philippines' sole strategic partner in the ASEAN region, our ties have spanned across various areas of cooperation, including defense and security, maritime, agriculture, and people-to-people relations.
Around 40 million Filipino people across the country continue to live without a formal water supply. As Rafael Bosano tells us, these people could bear the brunt of the El Niño phenomenon, which is expected to peak in the coming months.
The effects of the strong El Niño are projected in April and May, but as these images show, tight water supply is being experienced right now. State Weather Bureau Pagasa says Occidental Mindoro is among the 19 areas gripped under a dry spell.
Meron kaming batis na ano at meron naman deep well na pagdating ng summer ay hindi na sapat kasi nga kulang yung lalim. Siyempre natatakot ako dahil sa kakulangan ng daloy ng tubig ay isa yan talaga sa maaaring magkasakit yung aking mga kababayan.
The limited water supply has also forced the province to source vegetables from other areas.
Makakalungkot tingnan na ang gulay namin ay galing pang Manila. Ay samantalang malawak naman aming kabundukan para magtanim.
The residents of Looc are just some of the 40 million Filipinos in the country, or around 3 out of every 10 Filipinos who have no formal access to water.
Ibig sabihin nito ay hindi piped in water ang kanilang source. Maaring ito ay galing sa isang balon, isang shallow well na may poso, o kaya galing sa isang bukal or spring. Dahil itong mga lugar na to ang walang formal na supply ng tubig, inaasahan natin or tinataya natin na sila rin ang unang maapektuhan ng tagtuyot, both in terms of quality and quantity.
Other Filipinos are fortunate to receive stable water supply from service providers like the Metropolitan Water Works and Sewerage System. Water districts are those run by local government units and private water providers. However, David points out a huge infusion of money is needed to ensure access to water supply and distribution. He says the cost is around 250 billion pesos in 5 years. Philippine Environment Secretary Tony Yululoizaga says mayors whose towns are facing water supply problems are advised to get in touch with their agency to know where they can source their supply.
Begin to set the discussion kung saan sila pwedeng kumuha ng tubig, where the water supply na pwedeng nilang itap is located. The water resources have been mapped nationally already. So ang importante lang is to locate kung saan po sila at kung saan yung pinaka ma-efficient at maayos na water source.
Even before the El Nino advisory, the DENR, various experts and groups have advocated for water conservation and proper water consumption. Local chief executives are also advised to teach constituents the value of conserving this finite resource. But for Looc Mayor De La Torre, for areas already struggling with low water supply, they need more help than just lip service. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Education Department says teachers will be relieved of administrative tasks and non-teaching duties to allow them to focus on educating their students. Ara Perez has the details.
Marisa Acuña, a teacher in San Juan City TVL High School, wears many hats. Aside from being a communication and literature teacher, she also works as a librarian, resource coordinator, and advisor. With all these roles and responsibilities, she has no choice but bring her work home.
Siguro time management, pero minsan eh talagang ginugugol ko rin yung oras ko na supposed to be yung para sa me self naman, my me time naman, eh ginugugol ko na talaga yung oras ko doon para sa mga gawain kong dapat kong tapusin, lalo na kapag I have to beat the deadline.
However, a promise made by Education Chief Sara Duterte hopes to ease the burden of these teachers when she announced freeing teachers from administrative duties. For this school principal, it's one reform they've long been waiting for.
Makapag-focus yung mga guro sa pagbibigay ng quality education kasi wala na silang iisipin kung hindi magturo lang talaga at maghanda ng mga learning materials at strategies.
For a long time, teachers have been used to being assigned with administrative tasks. They are hopeful that Vice President and Education Secretary Sara Duterte will fulfill her promise of relieving them of these tasks so that they may solely focus on teaching.
The department order on the immediate removal of administrative tasks for teachers was released on January 26, and it involves hiring people for these tasks.
To ensure its effective implementation, along with the filling up of 5,000 administrative personnel for 2023 and another 5,000 administrative personnel for 2024, we will also be providing additional MOOE to enable our schools to hire the necessary administrative support staff. Let us bring our teachers back to the classrooms.
But why is the process of removing administrative duties from teachers taking a while? Education officials say they want to do it right.
Pag naglabas lang tayo ng DO without really making sure that on the ground it will be implemented effectively, mawawalang sa isa ilang po yung DO. At so ang ginawa po talaga natin is sinuri natin ano-ano yung mga tasks na ginagawa ng mga teachers, kasi meron ding mga teaching related, merong ancillary, merong admin tasks ang mga teachers. So kailangan natin suriin lahat yan, and then from there, kailangan natin malaman kung kanino natin ibibigay. And that comes with knowing kung ilang admin officers meron tayo, and ilang schools yung meron, ilang schools yung wala. Para yung mga wala, pwede tayong mag-clustering para magkaroon ng sasalo dun sa trabaho. That's why maglalabas din tayo ng isang internal memo within DepEd to guide the regional offices, division offices, kung saan at ano yung mga strategies para pag tinanggal natin yung admin task sa teachers, meron kasing kailangan sumalo nun.
POA shares one strategy could be clustering, wherein 2 to 3 administrative officers will handle about 3 schools, which he said is already being done by DepEd. Benjo Basas, chairperson of the Teachers Dignity Coalition, is happy about the plan, as teachers have long been complaining about the number of work they do that are not connected to teaching. He also hopes other staff shortages will also be addressed, including recruiting guidance counselors, property custodian, nurses, security officer, and other personnel that help run a school. Meantime, the Alliance of Concerned Teachers said each school must have at least two administrative staff to truly lessen the workload of teachers. For Justin Raagas, Executive Director of the Philippine Business for Education, this is a step in the right direction in solving the learning crisis. Raagas said it will also help if para-teachers or volunteers will be hired so that teachers don't feel that they have to do everything by themselves. She explained this is also the reason why teachers are not able to bring students up to the level they need to be because of the lack of time, which results in mass promotion. Ara Perez, ABS-CBN News.
Sky Cable will stop its cable TV operations effective February 27th. It issued an advisory which says it will now transition into a new internet service provider pursuant to the closing conditions of the PLDT Sky acquisition deal. Sky Fiber subscribers will continue to receive their internet service. The company adds current cable TV subscribers will not be charged anymore from January 27 until the end of broadcast on February 26. Meanwhile, ANC, the ABS-CBN News channel, will continue to be seen on TFC, Converge Vision, Provincial Cable, ANC 24/7 on YouTube, and the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel. Heads up, motorists, a fourth straight oil price hike looms next week. Estimates show gasoline prices could increase by as much as 2 pesos and 80 centavos per liter, while diesel could go up by up to 1 peso and 30 centavos. As for kerosene, prices may increase by at least 40 centavos. Philippine senators calling for suspension of lottery games amid allegations the recent results might have been rigged. The Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office successive Lotto winners have prompted lawmakers to open a probe on the game's integrity. Senator Aimee Marcos argues that irregularities in the game must be addressed first before continuing the draws.
Hanggat hindi napapaliwanag itong mga pangyayaring to, itigil muna yung bola. Wala nang naniniwala eh. At naaawa naman ako sa mga pumupustang mahihirap. Yan na lang ang tanging pag-asa nila na makaahon. Eh inaagaw pa, ninanakaw pa, binobola pa talaga.
Meanwhile, PCSO maintains there is nothing irregular about their Lotto game operations.
Kung ito ang may alingas-ngas, ang una hong hindi tataya ay yung mga empleyado.